Hey, Wolfpack, it's Crimson Wolf, and welcome back to Dragon Age Awakening. So, we are in the Dragonbone Waste, pretty much the final area of the game.
How do you stand living under all that rock?
Alright, let's see what we got into. So, last episode, we saved the city of Amaratine. What's that? I didn't mean to go over here. I hate fighting the children. No! Ugly bastards. Get off of me. I said, I'm gonna kill you. I hate the children. Ugly creatures. Isn't there a dragon in here? There is a dragon here. Oh. We got these things walking, everything about them is just ugly. Ah, no! I was about to kill it. Nathaniel, get this thing off of me. Nathaniel! Get it off! If I get attacked by one of those things again, I'm going to be pissed. This one has like there's something weird in one of these. Nope. Yeah, I'll go first. I'm not getting jumped by one of those things again. Alright, but this is a bit of an annoying area, if I remember right. There are things that make my game slow here. Oh, no, they killed that one. Okay. Oh, I definitely remember that mage. Is there an ogre here? Oh, snap. Yep. Kill the children first. The children are the evil ones. Oh, who did he grab? Grab Sigrun? Yep, Sigrun. Sorry, Sigrun. Can't help you. You just kick me? You big bloated bastard. Stop kicking me.
There is no glory in life.
Nope. Alright, come on, bring it. Hope I hop and chop your giant head off. Alright, everything is dead. A note. Yeah, there's still codexes in here to find. Which I kind of find very weird. Well, not weird, but you know, it is what it is. Ugly, ugly children. Oh, I just came from that way, didn't I? All right. Now, I remember there's two things that's in this area because we also come back here for witch hunt. So I'm trying to think which one of the two creatures are here. I'm pretty sure it's what I'm expecting it to. Oh, no, never mind. Oh, snap! Oh man, you tricked me, you stinking game. I thought the dragon actually wasn't gonna be here. And I get to kill another dragon. And this dragon actually is quite difficult, too. Look how giant this thing is. This seems a lot bigger than other dragons we fought for some reason. Get up, I can't see. Oh, I killed Sigrun. All right, Nathaniel, and I actually want to try killing this thing real quick. Go back there. Cause it'll give me another kill, dragon kill on my. Oh, not what I wanted. I want you to go back here and hold. Cause I can kill this thing. There we go. Douche. Alright, killed another dragon, guys. I am the dragon slayer. Can I not loot this dragon? I don't know why I would need to. I actually don't need to. But I would like to because dragon, hello. Valuable materials inside a dragon body. Alright guys, anyway, let's continue on. We're gonna go inside now. Dum-da-da-dum-dum. Okay, so we're in Drake's Fall. Pretty sure I know what's about to come up. Actually, before we go... Never mind.
I'm glad to see that you are well, sister.
Oh, Serani. Oh, thank Mithal, you're still alive. What has the architect done to you? Why are you with him?
The architect is kind to me. And tender. And he has told me his plan. The Darkspawn are just like us. The architect has freed them, and they search for a place in this world, just like the Dalish are searching. Everything he's done to help his people. You can respect that, can't you, sister?
I can respect that, but at the same time, they're Darkspawn. Valena, tell your sister don't buy this.
Serani, they killed our friends, and so many others! You remember?
I do. And this is why I must help them. They are like children come into the world with no understanding of what is good and fair. They have a bestial nature, but I've seen them overcome it. They just need to be shown how.
These are not like the werewolves. You know how they reproduce? They kidnap women, turn them into brood mothers. No, I'm not okay with this. I can't believe I want to tell you. And come with us and I'm trying to get her away from this craziness, so come with us so you can tell others.
No, I have work to do. The architect is waiting for me. And for you. He will explain everything. You will see as I have seen.
No! Don't go!
Great. Your sister's nuts. Because I am not siding with the architect, guys. I've already decided that. Because the idea of it is very ridiculous. Well. The idea of how they reproduce is what pretty much tells me no. Alright, so real quick, if you haven't played this, get these crystals. That's all you need to worry about is get these crystals. That first one is always a pain and you may miss it. But yeah, get those crystals, find them. Oh, I can't go, what? Yes I can. Oh, I can't. I'm like, can I go up here? I cannot. Alright, why is there oh, that's downstairs. Alright, so kill the Darkspawn. As usual. Ooh, nice decapitation. Nice, Valena. So yeah, I was gonna post and ask, hey, should I stop the architect or anything? And I decided not to, man, because brood mothers, that's my defining moment. That's my defining decision. It's the fact of how Darkspawn are, you know, reduced and everything. Is what's attacking me? Hello, big fella. You're like the third one I fought. I really wish they would stop doing it. Nope, do not put me in a corner. I don't like fighting in corners. Why am I feel like I'm way zoomed in right now? And I'm not usually this zoomed in. That's twice he has hit me. Buddy, you're really pissing me off. Alright. So next thing, if you want to still find these crystals, go through each of these little things. I'm going to take this just because I want to take it. You have to go to these flesh pods and look for the crystals. There should be... How many are there supposed to be? A socket. Oh, there's a socket. So I need 4. I have 2. I don't think it's that way. I think that's how I continue in the area. I have 3 right now. I should have 4 at this point, shouldn't I? I have 3 for some reason. When the heck did I get 3? Well, that's weird. So I'm seeing 1, 2, 3. That loot went off a body and I know it. Alright, so that's 4. I'm gonna try looting something. It might be on these
As you say.
Yep, see there's one right there. Okay, so maybe I have to loot the other talking darkspawn body as well. So I don't miss it. Oh, nope, it wasn't on him. So I do have another one, so that's very good. So that means I did have to go in here and get this one for the next area. Alright, so okay, I'm set. Oh guys, do not miss those crystals. I think there's one in this flesh thing. Going to the flesh pot. There we go. So I have 2 more. Look at these ugly little bastards. I hate the children. I cannot express that enough. Out of everything, I hate the children. Children are the second most annoying thing in this Dragon Age series. The first being spiders. Do you have a thing on you? I'm trying to see if he has a crystal on him. Nope, he doesn't. He had 3 gold though. It's funny. I think that's funny because I don't at this point need much gold. What are you fighting? I think he's glitched. Cause he's literally fighting nothing. I'm more than sure that the children have none of crystals. Yeah, he had 1. I'm not sure how many crystals I have at this point. I don't remember. I did not keep track. I'm pretty sure I have at least 3 now. Yeah, I have 3. 3 more. So I need 1 more for this area. Is this... This is not what architect. It is. Is it? It is.
And so we meet again. No, Uther. That is not how this must begin. I owe you an apology, Commander. When last we met, I intended to explain. Myself. Fate, however, intervened.
You experimented on me.
I restrained you, only to prevent the misunderstanding that occurred with the rest of your warder.
A misunderstanding?
What's up with that rock?
Did you not attack the Grey Wardens?
I sent the Wizard to ask for the Grey Wardens' help. I should have anticipated that you might view our approach as an attack. I am rarely able to judge how your kind will react. It was most unfortunate.
Unfortunate. That's the word you want to use for this. You killed a lot of people, man. Unfortunate. Yeah, exactly. You took those men and bled them dry.
The Grey Wardens that were brought to me were already dead.
You killed them!
I took their blood just as I took yours. Because I had little choice. Things have not gone as I planned. I only ask that you hear me out. Should you still wish to slay me afterwards, you may try.
Well, there's a number of reasons why I should kill you. But I'm just going to let y'all hear what he says, just so y'all can have an idea. Fine, I will hear you out.
My kind has ever been driven to seek out the old gods. This is our nature. When we find one, a blight has begun. Each time we attack your surface lands and you fight back until we are defeated, to break the cycle, my brethren must be freed of their compulsion. For that, I need Grey Warden blood.
How would you free the Darkspawn? Let's see. You're trying to stop the blights.
Hundreds of thousands of my kind are killed before each blight is ended. It is a plague on our race. We do not begin a blight because we crave power or destruction. We obey the call of the old gods without choice.
How would you free the darkspawn?
In order to become what you are, you drink the blood of my kind. To transform. Similarly, we must transform. I have created a version of your joining that uses the blood of Grey Wardens. You take the taint into yourself. What we take is your resistance. That is how my brethren are freed. In your blood lies the key to their immunity against the call of the old gods.
How did the darkspawn change afterwards? Actually, that's a good question.
Once they are freed, the darkspawn think for themselves. They speak. They act. Some, however, have reacted poorly.
The mother?
They are flawed, and they rage against me. The mother gathers them to stop me, as she seeks to stop you. I cannot defeat the mother alone. And I cannot free the darkspawn unless she is defeated. Our goals are the same.
This reeks of stupid.
Yep.
The last thing we need is more darkspawn thinking for themselves.
True.
Darkspawn or no, he has a good point. Do we really want to keep killing each other forever?
This is what my sister saw. An ally amongst the darkspawn. This is an opportunity we cannot pass up.
That rock is annoying.
Help me kill the mother. And after it is done, I will leave to continue my work.
How did you become freed?
I was born as I am, an outsider amongst my kind. Why? I do not know. Why does some of your kind become Grey Wardens? Why does some possess magic? I have no answers.
Pretty sure you're a magister from the Venter Imperium. And you probably tainted the Black City. That's what I'm going with. I don't think you were born this way. I think you were created this way. I'm not allying with you. Again, guys, I am not allying with the Architect because one, brood mothers. Two, darkspawn tank people. There is no reason for them to continue living, and the blight in itself is just wrong. These creatures should not exist, nor do I think they should exist or think for themselves. Everything about their creation was tainted. I mean, my mindset might be wrong about it, but the way they're created by itself just says they shouldn't, you know, be around. No, I will not help you. This ends here.
No, the Architect is a visionary. Don't be foolish.
But we could have stopped this cycle of blights and old gods.
How very unfortunate. But I cannot blame you. You are as bound to your nature as we are to ours. I am sorry, Uther. It appears that I will not be able to keep my promise after all. You will have to forgive me, Commander, for fighting to preserve my destiny.
Alright, let's get this done. Well, it looks like they all disapproved of my choices. Well, Belena and Nathaniel did. I understand why Belena did. As far as why Nathaniel did, I have no idea. We are literally in a final second to last final battle here. Man, he can really deal some damage, y'all. Look at him. Okay, dude, you're kind of messing me up. What is this? He's like setting fire and everything, man. Like, oh snap. Belena should be safe. I don't have a potion for you. Actually, I need to give you a injury kit because you got injured last time. I'm gonna put this right here in case you die. But in case you don't, just take that. Come on, die. Die, architect. Die. He is already bringing out so much fire down. Did he give me a misdirection hex? Oh no, it's gone now. Dude, you are taking a minute to go down. And I killed the architect. Oh, yeah, I forgot about Uther. Oh, they all went down again because of the fire. Like, literally, all of them went down because of the fire just now. I forgot you have to kill Uther too. And if you don't know who Uther is, she is a Grey Warden from the novel. What is it? Is the Calling? I forgot about Uther. Oh, I'm saving game again. Completely forgot I had to fight you too. Ah, well. Okay, so I should have enough crystals for here. So yeah, I think Jesha, I'll read the Calling if y'all want to know what happens prior to Awakening. I don't know if I've said that already. But you do find out a few things, and it ties back to King Merrick. A little bit to Alistair. If you don't know, now you're gonna get some clues and hints. Alright, so I have one crystal. I need three more. No, I need, let's see, three, six, five. I need five more. These crystals give you these little things over here, these attendants. So right now I have Tower of Trauma and Tower of Flame. It helps you in a final fight against the Mother. Why am I saving twice? What the hell? But yeah, not Architect is dead. I don't regret it. I never regret killing Architect. I never actually side with the Architect. Oh crap, no. The children. Help me, where am I going? Kill this ugly. Oh my god, this thing is ugly. Look at these things, man. You cannot tell me these things being alive are good. I'm happy that after you kill the Mother and everything, after you do all this, you never see these ugly bastards again. I cannot stand fighting these things. At least I hope you never see these things again in another Dragon Age game. They'll come back, they're gonna be uglier than they were. It's gonna be horrific. I'm pretty sure that these children have
I shall do it.
The crystals I need. Nope, grub. None of these things had the. Oh, it's that ugly. This is an ugly one I came out to. I can't see it because of this. Oh, he grabbed me! You son of a. As soon as I get down, I'm going to kill you. You're gonna grab me. Alright, come here, big guy. Oh, no! I didn't want to do that. Come here, you armored son of a. I can't see. In between the ogre and the hard place. Okay, can't see again. I hate it when that does that. The camera does not let you see very well in some positions. Oh, or anything, you're not gonna die. Do you have a crystal? Oh, dang it. You don't have a crystal. Why do you have money? Pretty sure none of these children have a crystal. I hate fighting the children. Alright, that makes two crystals. No, I'm not sure. Oh crap, there's a children to my left. No grub children. These ugly little children. You can even hear them crawling. Look at that one. That's the ugly ones. The ones with the little things coming out their back. I really hate those. Because they're ugly. Like they're the ugliest ones. Ooh. Look at that. Even how they attack it gets ugly. It's just, I don't know. It's like some kind of living cockroach. Wait, why did I say living cockroach? I meant to say like this is a like a giant cockroach. I don't know why I said living. But oh man, really more of them? And then you have like the mouths from like y'all have watched what's the movie? Oh, Blade, the third. What's the third Blade movie that gave those things that type of mouth? I don't even want to be around these things out there. They're just ugly. Okay. Really? More of these? Wait, do you have a crystal? No, you don't. Why do none of these things have a crystal? Stop sending the children here. I don't care for the children. Ah, one of these ugly bastards on top of me. See, look at this. Like, I'm gonna pause it, because look how ugly this thing is. It has little tentacle things coming out its back. It's so ugly. I don't even want to get close to it. Seriously, if you want... There's one thing I hate more than spiders in Dragon Age games. It's the stinking children. Because they're creepy, disgusting, and just nasty. The nasties. Alright, that's three crystals. I know there's a fourth one somewhere, I just don't know where. It's in this chest. Nathaniel, open the chest. Yep, there's another one. I'm pretty sure we need a whole nother crystal set. I could be wrong. Well. I never use all those abilities anyway, but they're just nice to have in case you want to use them. I'm pretty sure I haven't missed any. I'm fairly sure I haven't missed any. Alright, that's that one. What does this one do? Tower of Healing, so it heals my party. Alright, so now we gotta go down here, guys. Alright, let's go. Alright, guys, here we are. And I was trying to figure out why I don't have this last one. There are only three towers, and there are only 12 crystals. And I don't remember how you get this last one. I can't remember. If I remember before I do another thing, I'll tell you.
If it isn't the hero of the hour, the slayer of the mighty father, come to claim a reward. Oh, what a delicious day.
What is that?
By the ancestors, do all brood mothers smell this bad? Creators preserve us. I have never seen such foulness.
Am I not beautiful? Has the Grey Warden come now to slay the mother too? Will she join the father in oblivion?
I want answers. Let me see, what is this?
Answers? My, but you are brave. Once, beautiful music sang to us from the deep, called us near. We would search for that voice. But the father, he was flawed. He heard only a twisted shadow of it. He hated what it did to us. He said he wanted to free us, but all he brought us was silence. Dreadful silence. But now the father is gone. The mother can take her children deep into the earth and care for them, safe and sound.
What a beautiful thought. Until the next time you send them attacking us again. Let's see.
Oh, the mother knows your ways. You will not let her be, no, not after what she's done. So it must end. It all must come crashing down!
Yeah, she's crazy.
Perhaps we will hear the song again when we die. Oh, let it come. Let it come.
Oh, God. Hideous. Ah! Oh, well, I'll take it. Go, 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 go. God, this thing. Oh, she grabs Sigrun. Don't grab. Oh, snap. No, I don't want to be that close. I don't want to be that close. The ugliness of this thing is horrendous. Okay, get up, dude. Need you to get up. Okay, I don't need to know about these. Oh, Sigrun's dead? Man, y'all again. Y'all butts kicked already. Dude, take a potion. Elena's the only one that's, you know, in good position right now. Ah, what the heck? I don't want to be here. I'm gonna go in front of this thing because it. Oh, the thing is dead. Ah, shoot. Okay. Screw the tentacles. I'm going after the mother herself. God, these things are like every. Okay, you know what? Bring fire down on you. Burn, you evil. I keep getting knocked down. No, 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 not the children. Aha, paralysis. Am I inside her ugly butt? Where am I? I'm getting attacked by the children. God, you ugly son of a... Elena, help me. Get this thing off me. Oh. Okay. Oh wait, I'm on Elena. No, I don't want to be on Elena. Oh, she grabbed me. She grabbed me. Ah, let go. Let go. Oh, snap. No, she's gonna kill me. Dang, she let me. Oh, crap. Now I'm fighting the children. What is this? Oh, God. Too many children. Too many children. Oh, God, what the heck? Does she flame me all the way back here again? Oh, man. Just die. I need her to die. I need her to die. Oh, no, no, oh, grab me again, you stupid. Ah, let go of me. What are you doing? And she keeps flinging me away. I'm gonna kill you. I'm not gonna die. Gonna kill you. Going to kill you. Almost there. Dead. Oh, that's nasty. But it's done. After the deaths of both the architect and the mother, nearly all the remaining darkspawn fled back into the deep roads. The raids on Amaranthine came to an abrupt end. Although some of the architect's disciples likely escaped into the deep roads with the rest of their brethren, they have, so far, shown no inclination towards vengeance against the Grey Wardens who killed their savior. Yet the deep roads remain plagued by the darkspawn, and it seems certain that in time another blight will begin. The danger may have passed for now, but the cycle of the old gods continue. Word of the Grey Warden's heroic salvation of Amaranthine spread like wildfire. When the magnitude of the losses at Vigil's Keep came to light, sympathy drove generous donations from all over Ferelden into the region's coffers. Amaranthine was restored to her former glory within a year, Vigil's Keep in 5. Because of the Warden's support for law and order in Amaranthine, Constable Aiden and his men were able to distribute the smuggler's goods to the battered survivors in the grueling days that followed the Darkspawn defeat. The Ardian's peasants suffered greatly during the war, and suffered yet worse in the years that followed. Success at the first rite of Vigil's Keep emboldened them, and thus other uprisings followed, often put down with brutality. Although the war devastated many farms in the Ardian, all agreed the loss would have been greater without soldiers for protection. The farmholders developed a certain reverence for the Warden Commander, as well as an ongoing reliance on the Grey Wardens for order and protection. Vigil's Keep stood alone against the Horde of Darkspawn. The Mother's forces outnumbered the Vigil's defenders many times over. But the sturdy dwarven walls proved impervious to any boulders an ogre could throw. The Vigil's soldiers, clad in silverite, each felled a dozen Darkspawn before they died. The Vigil held one night, then two, then a week, and eventually the attacking horde broke upon her walls. The Keep developed an almost mythic reputation, the few survivors immortalized in song and legend. The Vigil became a trading hub that would eventually eclipse the city of Amaranthine, with traders reassured by guards continually patrolling the pilgrim's path. But prosperity bred scheming and treachery between merchants and nobles, testing the commander's patience for years to come. Peace allowed the Wardens to replenish their numbers. Soon, Vigil's Keep bore a capable army with Wardens at its core. From their ranks emerged new heroes to challenge threats to Amaranthine and all of Ferelden. Through taxes and levies, the Vigil was rebuilt. Years later, Baldric stood on the battlements and pronounced that the defenses were acceptable. He would never speak more highly of any human engineering. Dark whispers of conspiracy against the Wardens fell silent after a rash of accidents and disappearances culminated in the apparent suicide of Ban Esmerel. The nobles of Amaranthine remained dutiful, some even suggest they were cowed into submission. Among the many legends that the Vigil spawned was one of the great heroes of the next age, a sheep herder turned soldier by the name of Sir Alec the Valiant, who eventually founded an order of knights that lasted 1,000 years. The commander's blade, Vigilance, crafted from the bones of an ancient dragon, was boldly stolen by Antiban crows. The blade changed hands many times thereafter, with some master swordsmen pursuing the weapon their entire lives. Some claim that this legendary blade has had a life of its own, and that its power is still steadily growing. Dworkin further refined his lyrium sand explosives, but left the Warden's employ after Qunari mercenaries tried to assassinate him. Although the Dwarven bombarder took his secrets with him, the Lerns say he left clues for others to follow in his footsteps. The Vigil's soldiers, wearing the distinctive silverite armor that Master Wei crafted, came to be known as the Silver Order. Under the tutelage of the Wardens, the Silver Order developed into one of Ferelden's most revered military forces, a lasting memory of the Vigil's famous commander. With Valanian architect gone from the region, the Pilgrim's Path began to see traffic again. The massacre of the militiamen and merchants, however, led to hostilities between the neighboring human settlements and any Daedric clans that passed by. One human villager soon kidnapped and murdered a Daedric child. The clans reacted by giving the Winding Wood a wide berth, but both sides know that at some point the elves will return for revenge. A few years after Kel'Harad was emptied of Darkspawn, Ozamar began sending expeditions to rediscover the knowledge of smithing that had been lost within the Taig.
Eventually, House Helmy decided that Kalarol was too important to be abandoned. At a tremendous cost of dwarven lives, they cleared the tunnels leading to Kalarol of all darkspawn, making the road between Ulzamar and the fortress safe again. Kalarol was reclaimed for Ulzamar once and for all. As promised, Valdrick and Dworkin presented Ulzamar's Shaper with the stone marker that told of how Kalarol's castes had taken up arms against the darkspawn. The Commander of the Grey was invited to Ulzamar as a guest of honor at a feast commemorating the defenders of Kalarol. The Shaper read the names of the castes off the marker, then proceeded over a ceremony to return them to the stone, as befitted warriors of their stature. In time, the Arnon began to forget the tales of apparitions in the Black Marsh, and ever so slowly settlers drifted into the region. Scotter said the veil was still thin and thus the area still dangerous, but the people only cared that there were no longer frightening whispers in the shadows. The village was slowly rebuilt. Twice the Baroness mansion was rebuilt and occupied, once by a wealthy merchant and another time by a Norwegian mage. Both died mysteriously. Afterwards, the mansion was torn down completely and the site left untouched. The survivors of the siege at Vigil's Keep hailed Anders and his magic for holding back hundreds of assaulting darkspawn. In the ensuing victory celebration, the men dragged the mage to the fire to engage him in a drinking contest, in which Anders lost. Anders remained with the Grey Wardens a few years longer, training the Order's next generation of mages. But when the Circle Tower called him to deliver a lecture on the nature of the architect, much to the Templar's dismay, Anders told the Commander of the Grey that his time with the Wardens was over. And yet, not 2 months later, Anders returned to the Order. Ever after, the Wardens were his home and his lasting companions. Vlaina never saw her clan again, but neither did she forsake her dangerous culture, nor her sharp tongue, nor her quick temper. Her friendship with the Warren Commander changed her opinions of humankind significantly. Shortly after the Mother's defeat, darkspawn stragglers who still remained on the surface attacked the human village. Vlaina was the only warden nearby and defended the village single-handedly. She did not sneer once. Vlaina scoured the Mother's lair for signs of her sister, but it was as though Serani had vanished into thin air. Vlaina blamed the Warren Commander for choosing to kill the architect, certain that the architect would have released her sister if he lived. This remained a source of friction for as long as Alexander and Vlaina knew each other. Over the next years, Nathaniel dedicated himself to the Order and to clearing the blemishes on his family's name. After saving Taryn Fergus Clusen from a bandit attack, a portion of Amaranthine was returned to the house. Nathaniel passed the holding to Delilah's son, and when a new castle was eventually built there, a statue of Nathaniel was erected in its courtyard. Justice fought valiantly at the battle for Vigil's Keep, but before the victory horn sounded, a darkspawn sword removed Kristoff's head. It was, of course, unclear whether the Spirit of Justice perished or simply departed. At the least, Kristoff's wife Aura was finally able to reclaim her husband's ashes. With the Mother dead, Sigrun seemed to lose her purpose. She withdrew from her friends in the Order and spoke to them less and less each day. One morning, Sigrun was simply absent, her bed made and her trunk emptied. A young recruit who had been up in the night said she had left for her calling, gone to finish what she had started in Kalharal. At Vigil's Keep, Ogryn rallied a last-minute defense of the gate, taking on two ogres simultaneously to allow others time to regain the courtyard. He eventually passed out from blood loss, and when he awoke weeks later, nobody was more surprised than he to discover he had been credited as a hero. Ogryn continued to regale young Warren's recruits with tales of his prowess, both in battle and bed. His drinking games prompted at least one recruit to declare that she'd rather reattempt the joining than lift another mug. At the Warren Commander's urging, Ogryn took a more active role in his child's life. He visited Felsey often and wrote letters, which the Warren Commander graciously proofread nearly every week. As for the Savior of Ferelden, he did not remain as Commander of the Grey for long.
The Darkspawn were no longer a real concern, and the blight well and truly over. It was time for him to move on. Some claimed the commander headed west into Arlee, chasing after the dark-haired sorceress who had fought alongside him during the blight. Whether he found her or not, he certainly did not return to Vigil's Keep. So guys, that's going to do it for Awakening. I want to thank you so much for watching. And if you enjoyed this, hit that like button, share the video. And if you want to join the Wolfpack, please subscribe below. Guys, we're going to continue going with this series. The next thing we're going to do is Guardians of Amgrak. Again, I want to thank you guys very much for watching. And I hope you tune in tomorrow whenever you decide to watch it for the next part of the series. Again, guys, I want to thank you very much. And I will see you next time, Wolfpack, on Dragon Age.